the Gulf of Mexico, 130 miles from shore. Auger, 50,000 tons of engineering masterpiece, has been anchored in 2,800 feet of water for 20 years.
Auger clearly was a deep water pioneer.
After a lifetime of drilling milestones, Auger was scheduled to retire. But one elusive oil field still remained. Auger had one last shot, and it hit the jackpot, kickstarting an historic comeback.
Auger makes Cardamom possible. Cardamom extends the life of Auger.
This is the story of Shell's legendary deep water platform and the oil field that's reinventing it.
We're going to be testing another line that comes from the UTP panel.
This deep water drill rig and production facility looks like many others in the Gulf of Mexico. But Auger's unique.
Auger's a special platform for me. The first TLP I've ever worked on is very special to me. It's my home for 17 years.
Three decades ago, a rig this far offshore, in water this deep, was considered impossible.
It was generally thought by the industry, as late as the early 1980s, that beyond the shelf edge, which would be in water depths greater than 600 to 1,000 feet, there was likely not going to be commercial accumulations of oil and gas.
In the late 80s, everyone thought offshore technology had reached its limit with Bullwinkle. Installed in 1,300 feet of water and five times the height of the Statue of Liberty, it still holds the record for the tallest structure ever placed in the sea.
You're building this enormous structure, almost 1,500 feet tall, and perched up on top of it is the usable part of the building. It's like building the largest skyscraper in the world and occupying the top two floors. The rest of it is just holding it up above the waves.
But Shell wanted to drill in water twice as deep as Bullwinkle's. It required a new breed of platform and a giant leap of faith. Plans for the world's first tension leg platform, a rig anchored into the deep sea floor, were drawn up.
The tension leg platform, the concept was enormous. It was game-changing in many ways. It floats on large pontoons, and the connection to the seafloor is not through the fixed structure, but rather through what are called tendons that hold it in place, and they're under tension.
In the mid-90s, Auger, the pioneer tension leg platform, or TLP, began drilling at an unprecedented depth. Its design was quickly replicated. Four more were built and installed in the Gulf. As the new century approached and the oil directly below Auger diminished, it found a new lease of life as a hub, processing oil from deep water fields up to 20 miles away.
So from the TLP, you can actually control what goes on those wells that are located many miles away on the seabed.
But in 2008, Auger's six subsea fields began to slow. She was scheduled for an oil rig's inevitable fate, decommissioning.
Nice and easy, buddy.
Auger's decline or end of life is somewhere around 2015.
But talk turned to a mysterious new field that might be nearby, Cardamom. The elusive oil field had been hidden beneath a vast, impenetrable salt deposit, 6 miles below the sea floor.
We've always known that the oil was down there, or thought it was, but it wasn't until more recently, with some of the new seismic tools that we have, that we actually could prove that it was there and actually make it worthwhile to go after it.
But reaching Cardamom meant drilling a well like no other. Using a directional drilling technique, Auger pierced the seafloor and steered the drill 2 miles horizontally through the Earth's crust, around the salt deposit, directly into the oil.
When you drill wells at that depth, they're 8 inches in diameter. 2 miles might as well be the other side of the solar system.
At 31,000 feet from the drill deck, this was the longest directional well ever made, right into a giant find.
It's always a gamble because you can never be sure. You're always going to be making your best guess. What it tells you about the Gulf of Mexico is that there's probably still a lot to be done there that will keep the industry busy for a very long time.
Auger was saved from imminent decommissioning. But in 2010, as Auger geared up for its big break, disaster struck when a blowout at the Deepwater Horizon oil rig killed 11 crew. The well gushed into the Gulf for 87 days, creating the worst accidental marine oil spill in history. A 6-month moratorium on drilling in the Gulf left Auger's Cardamom discovery in limbo. Stricter regulations were introduced, but Shell's robust approach to operating safely and responsibly meant that Auger was the first rig to recommence drilling.
In the last couple years, we've actually doubled capacity on the platform. Once Cardamom comes on stream, we're going to add another 60% on top of that.
And now, Cardamom is almost ready to come online. But not before Auger's multi-billion dollar upgrade is complete. Soon, this deepwater veteran will be able to handle the mighty Cardamom.
Auger's old, she's 20 years old. There's a lot of work, there's a lot of money being spent on Auger. We're revitalizing the platform to make it a platform that'll last another 20 years.
Auger very much was a pioneer, and you could say now with Cardamom as a 6-mile deep subsalt discovery, Auger continues to be a pioneer.
Today, Auger's history has made it a deep water legend. It's a success story unlike any other in offshore exploration.
In 1997, I never thought that we would be here long enough for me to retire. Now that Cardamom has come on board, I love Auger, so maybe I could retire right here.